Hello everyone, I am Vijayas Kulalakai, Assistant Professor of Vijayanagara College, Hospet. Already I have explained you the general characteristics of phylum Protozoa. Today let us discuss about the classification of phylum Protozoa. The phylum Protozoa is classified into four classes based on their locomotory organs. They are as follows. First class, Sarcodina or Rhizopoda. Let us discuss the characteristics of the class Rhizopoda one by one. They are free living or parasites. They dwell in fresh water and some of them in marine water and in moist places. The next character, the body is covered by shell and naked. Naked means there is no any covering. Pseudopodia are the locomotory organs and also help to capture the food. It is the unique character, that is, body shape is changeable due to the presence of pseudopodia, which brought about the temporary outpushings of the cytoplasm. The mode of nutrition is holozoic. The reproduction takes place by both sexual and asexual method. The first example of the class Rhizopoda is amoeba. Second example is Entamoeba histolytica. Third one is Elphidium. Fourth example is Arcella. The second class is Mastigophora or Flagellata. The following are their characteristics. Locomotory organ is thread-like flagella. The contractor vacuole is present for osmoregulation. Their asexual reproduction is by binary fission and cyst formation. The sexual reproduction is absent in them. The examples of the class Flagellata is Euglena, Volvox, Trypanosoma, Leishmania donovani. The third class is Ciliata or Ciliophora. Now let us discuss its general characteristics. Now let us discuss this class characteristics one by one. The first one is they are free living or parasitic. They are binucleated. The nucleus is divided into micronucleus and macronucleus. You can see in this diagram. Their locomotory organs are cilia. Their asexual reproduction is by binary fission and sexual reproduction is by conjugation. By formation of conjugation breed, they exchange their genetic materials. The examples of the class Ciliata is Paramecium, Opalina, Balantidium, Verticella, Nyctotherus. The fourth class is Sporozoa. The following are their characteristics. Locomotory organelles and contractile vacuole are absent. All members of these groups are endoparasites. A thick pellicle is present in their bodies. Their asexual reproduction is by binary fission and sexual reproduction is by gamogony. The example of the class Sporozoa is Plasmodium, Monocystis, Gregarina. Like other animals, amoeba also moves from one place to another. This movement is carried out by a finger-like outgrowth of the body called pseudopodia. This type of motion is called pseudopodial locomotion or amoeboid locomotion. Theories regarding amoeboid locomotion explains about how pseudopodia are formed and it brings about locomotion. The first theory is contraction hydraulic theory proposed by Schultz. The body of amoeba is divided into outer ectoplasm called as plasmogel and inner endoplasm called as plasmozole. Due to contraction of plasmogel at the posterior end, a current is produced in the protoplasm. This current pushes the plasmozole at the anterior end, and this results in the formation of new pseudopodium anteriorly, and the body moves in that direction. Second theory is surface tension theory. This theory was proposed by Berthold. This theory says that the pseudopodium is formed from the surface of the body by a change in surface tension. Now let us discuss this theory step by step. The first step is protoplasm is a fluid. It remains spherical due to surface tension. Second step, the surface tension may be decreased at any point on the surface due to external changes. Third step, at the point of low surface tension, the protoplasm flows out in the form of pseudopodium. The fourth step and the last step is the amoeba now moves in the direction of pseudopodium. Third theory is rolling movement theory. It is proposed by Jennings. According to this theory, the amoeba moves by the rolling of the body on the substratum. This is brought about by the streaming movement of the cytoplasm. This type of movement is exhibited by the amoeba verrucosa. Fourth theory is walking movement theory proposed by Dellinger. According to this theory, amoeba walks on the substratum using pseudopodia as legs. During its movement, the pseudopodium located at the anterior end is firmly attached to the substratum. It contracts and pulls the body forward. Another pseudopodium is formed and it is attached to the substratum in front of the previous one, and the process is repeated. As you can see in this slide, the last theory is Sol-Gel theory, proposed by Hyman. Later it is supported by Pantin and Mast. The plasma lemma is attached to the substratum. At the anterior end, the plasma gel is converted into plasmozole, which is called solation. The plasmozole of the posterior end contracts. This produces a hydraulic pressure on the plasmozole located inside. As a result of the hydraulic pressure, the plasmozole is pushed forward as a small projection. By the continuous accumulation of plasmozole, the pseudopodium is formed. At the periphery of the pseudopodium, the plasmozole is converted into the plasmogel. Thus, pseudopodium contains an outer plasma lemma, a middle plasma gel, and the inner plasmozole. The plasma gel of the posterior end at the junction of plasmodule and plasma gel is continuously changed into plasmodule and it flows forward. This results in the withdrawal of pseudopodium from the posterior end and helps the continuous supply of plasmodule to the developing pseudopodium at the anterior end. By producing pseudopodia continuously in one direction, amoeba slowly moves. Refer this diagram for better understanding. Here you can see amoeba engulfing the food. Thank you.